Hello everyone, we have Ian from VMware here, and he's going to help us understand the VMware certification track. Ian, why don't you introduce yourself?
Thank you. I'm Ian Worrell with VMware Education, Senior Technical Instructor. So we've been looking at the certification tracks from ourselves, a number of tracks: data center virtualization, network virtualization, the cloud management and automation, desktop and mobility, and of course digital workspace. The air motion side thing, as we used to call it. Concentrating on vSphere, but what a lot of people start with is VMware vSphere's install, configure, and manage course.
This one, right?
This one in the middle.
Yeah.
The foundations exam, that is based upon that course. Yeah, there's a few extra questions around the broader portfolio of VMware courses, products, I should say. You can do that one from home, book it, take it over the web, pass that one. We suggest you do the vSphere Optimizer Scale course. That covers Enterprise Plus license features, the ones that are not all covered in the install configure manual. So there's extra information there, but you don't have to attend it in order to take the next exam. Okay, the data center virtualization, VMware certified professional.
And what is the new name which they are coming up with the exam?
For certification, we are now using the year that you took and passed the exam. That is going to go in with the title of your VMware certified professional. So if you pass that now, it's BCP from data center virtualization 2019. If you pass it from the 1st of January onwards, it'll have 2020. We are not retiring those exams. So if I took an exam now, I became 2019 BCP DCV, it still would be valid in 2025 and beyond. Potential employers would know I hadn't done anything with VMware since 2019, but I could go and take any of the other courses, and there'll be a lot more on the web.
So just a quick question. So for the question is basically, if the certifications are not expiring, that's right, but when VMware releases the next version, you have to eventually certify for the new version, and the older version will expire when it goes end of life. Can you give me a little bit on that?
Right, so nothing is going to expire.
Oh.
So when we are on the vSphere, let's call it .next version, you have a new exam track.
Yeah.
You could go with the .next version for your 2019 certification, which could be on vSphere 6.5, could be on vSphere 6.7, and the title of the exam will tell you. So anyone looking at your certification will see you done it in perhaps 6.5. Some people have done it in 6.7, but it'll have the year that you passed it. That will never expire. New versions will say vSphere.next, BCP, data center virtualization, next year 2020. Okay, but it will have the version of our product as well as the year that you passed that exam and got the certification.
Cool.
Never expires, that's the important thing.
Brilliant.
I think you're asking for.
Yes, thank you very much. Thank you very much for that.
Thank you.
Can we go a little bit further from VCDX? Just for people who are already on VCP and want to go jump ahead.
Right, so you are already VCP. We recommend again courses. We've got some workshop courses for these, which troubleshooting, how to actually administer the system, much more hands-on. However, the next certification tracks, you don't need the courses. You could just go to look at two sets of exams. One is the deployment exam. That is the doing. The exam will be on a live environment, very much like you'll see in our hands-on labs, that sort of environment. The questions, 17 of them, in roughly 2.5 hours, they are scenarios. So it will ask you things like, give me a strong password on ESXi, and you have to go onto the environment and set that password. 17 different scenarios around different areas. You don't even get the results straight away. There's a marking script will happen when you finish the exam, and 45 minutes, an hour later, you will get an email telling you, hopefully, that you passed. You've got enough marks there. So that'll be the deployment exam. It's a a VCAP. That's the one, the VMware Certified Advanced Professional. So that's the one in deployment. There is also a design one, which will ask you, again, scenarios, but more...
Design one, this
that's
one,
that's
yeah.
the one. But more of the multiple choice and free form answers with that one. Pass those two, they're both separate advanced professional exams. If you pass both of them, you'll get a VCIX. That's the implementation expert. You've really done well to get to that level. Now, anyone that really wants to prove themselves, we've got something which is almost like a doctor sort of level in the educational world, the VCDX. Not so many of those in the world. VCDX available in all of these tracks I was talking about. Let's stick with vSphere. You will have to submit a full design. Ideally, you'll have been involved in some project because you will know it a lot better. You will have to pay to submit that design, and we will get a bunch of experts to look through it. You then have to come and defend it. So we suggest prepare maybe a couple of dozen slides to present your design. That panel of experts will ask you to defend it. That they will have worked out what might not be good about the design. They will absolutely grill you. You ought to have more slides to try and explain a lot of why you did things a certain
so
way.
So basically you have to go and present it in the panel.
You do, and defend it.
And there is a panel.
There is a panel of human beings, experts. They will be VCDX themselves.
Nice.
And again, they will come back to you after they've discussed it. Did you defend it well enough? Was your design robust enough? Have you covered all the angles you should? You get that one, that never expires either. Okay, that is for life.
Nice.
If you pass that one, you're good enough never to expire that service.
Thank you very much, Ian, for giving us time.
Absolute pleasure.
Thanks a lot. Cheers.
Thank you.